Assalamu alaikum. I am Dr. Aisha. Today we will be discussing arteries on the sole of the foot. Main arteries supplying the sole of the foot are medial plantar artery and lateral plantar artery. Both these arteries are branches of posterior tibial artery. As I have already told you in my previous lecture that popliteal artery, it gives off two branches, anterior tibial artery and posterior tibial artery. Posterior tibial artery, it runs in the posterior compartment of the leg. As you can see here, this is the posterior tibial artery. This posterior tibial artery, it then passes deep to the flexor retinaculum in the tarsal tunnel. Tarsal tunnel, which you already know, is the osteofibrous tunnel deep to the flexor retinaculum. Okay. This posterior tibial artery, it passes deep to the flexor retinaculum and gives off two branches, which are medial plantar and lateral plantar arteries. Both medial and lateral plantar arteries, they supply skin, muscles and bones on the sole of the foot. They supply all the toes through different branches. We'll talk about these branches individually. This posterior tibial artery, it also gives off calcaneal branches, which you can see here. These calcaneal branches, they supply the calcaneum and the heel area on the sole of the foot. Let's begin with the cores and branches of the medial plantar artery. Now the first artery supplying the sole of the foot is medial plantar artery. This one is the medial plantar artery. This is an image showing arterial supply on the sole of the foot. This is posterior tibial artery. As I have already told you, posterior tibial artery, it divides into two terminal branches deep to the origin of abductor hallucis muscle. The smaller terminal branch of posterior tibial artery is the medial plantar artery, this one. This medial plantar artery, it lies along the medial border on the sole of the foot, like this. This medial plantar artery, it gives off three branches which supplies the sole of the foot. The first branch is the cutaneous branch or the superficial branch of the medial plantar artery, which supplies the skin over the medial side of the sole, this one. The second branch of medial plantar artery is the muscular branch, this one. This muscular branch, it supplies the muscles of the great toe. This is the great toe. Muscles of the great toe are supplied by muscular branch of the medial plantar artery. Then the medial plantar artery, it gives off three superficial digital branches. These three branches, which you can see here, these are the superficial digital branches of the medial plantar artery. These superficial digital branches, they join the first, second, third plantar metatarsal arteries, which are branches of the plantar arch. We'll talk about plantar arch in a while. For now, just remember, these superficial digital branches, they join the first three plantar metatarsal arteries on the sole of the foot. Now the second artery on the sole of the foot is lateral plantar artery. This is the posterior tibial artery, which is passing deep to the flexor retinaculum. This is the lateral plantar artery, which is the larger terminal branch of posterior tibial artery. This lateral plantar artery, it runs laterally and anteriorly like this on the sole of the foot. After reaching the base of the fifth metatarsal bone, at this point, this lateral plantar artery, it gives off a superficial branch which is supplying the skin and fascia over the lateral half of the sole of the foot. I repeat, lateral plantar artery starts at this point
deep to the flexor retinaculum. It courses laterally and anteriorly on the sole of the foot like this. At this point, at the level of base of fifth metatarsal bone, it gives off a superficial branch and it becomes continuous as the plantar arch like this. It then moves medially as the plantar arch. Okay, talking about branches of the lateral plantar artery, like medial plantar artery, it also gives off a cutaneous branch which supply the skin and fascia on the lateral side of the sole of the foot. It also gives off muscular branches of the lateral plantar artery. It supplies the muscles on the sole of the foot. The third branch given off by this artery is the anastomotic branch. These anastomotic branches, they reach the lateral border of the foot like this, and the anastomose with the arteries on the dorsum of the foot. These are the anastomotic branches of the lateral plantar artery. The last branch given off by the lateral plantar artery is the calcanean branch. This calcanean branch, it supplies the skin over the heel at this point. That's all about the course and branches of the lateral plantar artery on the sole of the foot. Now we'll talk about the plantar arch, this one, the deep plantar arch, which is the direct continuation of the lateral plantar artery. Now let's begin the origin and course of deep plantar arch on the sole of the foot. This is a transverse section through the sole of right foot, which is indicating the course of lateral plantar artery and the deep plantar arch. This one is the deep plantar arch. This layer of muscles, which you can see here, is the first layer of muscles on the sole of the foot. This is the second layer. This is third layer of muscles, and these small one are the interossei muscles arising from the adjacent sides of the metatarsal bones, and they form the fourth layer of the muscles on the sole of the foot. This is the first metatarsal bone. This is second, third, fourth, and fifth metatarsal bone. This is lateral side of the foot. This is medial side of the foot. Now let's begin the origin of the plantar arch. This is lateral plantar artery, which initially passes deep to the first two layers of muscles like this. After reaching the base of the fifth metatarsal bone at this point, it gives off a superficial branch, which I have already told you supplies the skin over the lateral part of the sole of the foot. It then continues medially between the third and fourth layer of muscles as the plantar arch like this. At this point, which is the proximal end of the first intermetatarsal space, this lateral plantar artery is joined by the deep branch of dorsalis pedis artery given off in the first metatarsal space. If you remember, I told you in my previous lecture that dorsalis pedis artery, after reaching the proximal end of the first intermetatarsal space, it gives off a first dorsal metatarsal artery which supply the great toe, dorsal surface of the great toe. After giving off this dorsal metatarsal artery, the dorsalis pedis artery, it runs or dips down between the two heads of first dorsal interosseous muscle and enters the sole of the foot. This deep artery or deep branch of dorsalis pedis artery, it joins the lateral plantar artery and completes the deep plantar arch on the sole of the foot between the third and fourth layer of muscles. So I repeat, the plantar arch, what is the origin of plantar arch? It is basically the continuation of the lateral plantar artery, and the course of the plantar arch, it begins at the base of fifth metatarsal bone at this point, and it continues medially up to the point, this point, proximal part of first intermetatarsal space. This whole arch, which you can see here between the third and fourth layer of muscles, is the plantar arch. Now let's talk about the branches of the plantar arch.
This is an image showing branches of the plantar arch. This is the plantar arch, this transverse arch which you can see here. It begins at the level of base of fifth metatarsal bone and ends at the level of first intermetatarsal space. On the medial side, this arch is joined by, or you can say it is completed by the deep branch of dorsalis pedis artery, this one. This is the complete deep plantar arch. This plantar arch, it gives off four plantar metatarsal arteries, which are 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are the four plantar metatarsal arteries which arise from this deep plantar arch and run distally, one in each intermetatarsal space. Each plantar metatarsal artery, it further divides into two branches like this. These are the proper plantar digital arteries, which supply the adjacent sides of the two toes like this. In addition to these plantar metatarsal arteries, the first plantar metatarsal artery, it also gives off a branch to the medial side of the great toe, this one. This branch, which is supplying the medial side of the great toe, arises from the first plantar metatarsal artery. I repeat, plantar arch, it gives off four plantar metatarsal arteries which run one in each intermetatarsal space. Each plantar metatarsal artery, it further divides into two proper plantar digital arteries which supply the adjacent sides of the toes. This first plantar metatarsal artery, it also gives off a branch to the medial side of the great toe. Lateral side of the fifth toe, it receives a direct branch from the lateral plantar artery.
Second set of branches which arise from the plantar arch are three proximal perforating arteries, 1, 2, and 3. These small arteries which you can see here, these are the proximal perforating arteries which arise from the plantar arch. These proximal perforating arteries, they pass through the second, third, and fourth intermetatarsal spaces and communicate with the dorsal metatarsal arteries, which are branches of the arcuate artery. I told you in my previous lecture that dorsal metatarsal arteries, they communicate with the plantar metatarsal arteries. This communication is through these proximal perforating arteries, which run in the second, third, and fourth intermetatarsal spaces. We have another set of perforating arteries through which the plantar and dorsal arteries, they communicate. which are the distal perforating arteries, which you can see here. These are the four distal perforating arteries. These distal perforating arteries, they arise from the distal end of each plantar metatarsal artery and they join the distal part of the corresponding dorsal metatarsal artery. That's all about the branches of the plantar arch on the sole of the foot.
Here is another image indicating the communication between dorsal and plantar metatarsal arteries through proximal and distal perforating arteries. Let's have a review of this. This is navicular bone, this is the cuneiform bone, this is metatarsal bone, and these are the three phalanges of the toes: proximal phalanx, middle phalanx, and the distal phalanx. This is dorsal surface of the foot, this is plantar surface of the foot. As you already know, this is arcuate artery, which is the third branch of dorsalis pedis artery on the dorsum of the foot. This arcuate artery gives off dorsal metatarsal artery, this one. This is dorsal metatarsal artery, which further gives off two branches, which are the dorsal digital arteries, which supply the adjacent sides of the toes on the dorsum of foot. As you can see here, these dorsal digital arteries, they end before reaching the distal phalanx of the toe. They give supply to the proximal and middle phalanx only. It ends before reaching the distal phalanx of the toes. Now comes the deep plantar arch, this one, which lies on the sole of the foot and is the continuation of lateral plantar artery. I have already told you this. This deep plantar arch, it gives off the plantar metatarsal arteries. This one is the plantar metatarsal artery, which further divides into plantar digital arteries for the adjacent sides of the toes. This green colored artery, usually we indicate arteries with the red color, but I have marked this artery with the green color so that it could be more prominent for you. It could become more prominent for you. This is the proximal perforating artery, this is the distal perforating artery. Proximal perforating artery, as you can see, it connects deep plantar arch with the proximal part of the dorsal metatarsal artery, whereas the distal perforating artery, it connects plantar metatarsal artery with the distal end of the dorsal metatarsal artery.
This is an image showing complete arterial supply on the sole of the foot. Let's have a review of the arterial supply of sole. This is posterior tibial artery. It gives off two terminal branches. The first one is medial plantar artery. The second one is lateral plantar artery. This medial plantar artery, it runs along the medial border of the foot. It supplies skin over the medial side of the sole of the foot. It supplies muscles of the great toe. It gives off three superficial digital branches, 1, 2, and 3. These three superficial digital branches, they join the first three plantar metatarsal arteries like this. Then comes the lateral plantar artery. Lateral plantar artery, it runs laterally and anteriorly along the sole of the foot at the level of base of fifth metatarsal bone. It gives off a superficial branch and continues medially as the plantar arch. This lateral plantar artery or the plantar arch is joined on the medial side by the deep branch of dorsalis pedis artery, which dips down by passing between the heads of the first dorsal interosseous muscle. This is the plantar arch. This plantar arch then gives off four plantar metatarsal arteries, 1, 2, 3, and 4 plantar metatarsal arteries. Each plantar metatarsal artery further divides into two proper digital arteries, which supply the adjacent sides of the toes. Medial side of the toe is supplied by a direct branch from the first plantar metatarsal artery, and lateral side of the toe is supplied by a branch from the lateral plantar artery. Then we have three proximal perforating arteries, which are branches of the plantar arch. Through these proximal perforating arteries, they communicate with the dorsal metatarsal arteries, proximal ends of the dorsal metatarsal arteries. Then comes the distal perforating arteries. These distal perforating arteries, they connect the plantar metatarsal arteries with the distal end of dorsal metatarsal arteries. That's all about the arterial supply on the sole of the foot. This is a flow sheet showing arteries on the sole of the foot. We have posterior tibial artery, which divides into two terminal branches. The first one is medial plantar artery, the second one is lateral plantar artery. They supply, or they give blood supply to the sole of the foot. This lateral plantar artery, it joins the deep plantar artery, which is the main continuation of dorsalis pedis artery. They join to form the deep plantar arch on the sole of the foot. This deep plantar arch, it gives off four plantar metatarsal arteries. These plantar metatarsal arteries, they gives off plantar digital branches, which supply the adjacent sides of the toes. Deep plantar arch, it gives three proximal perforating arteries. These proximal perforating arteries, they connect the deep plantar arch with the proximal end of the dorsal metatarsal arteries. Each plantar metatarsal artery, it gives off a distal perforating artery. These distal perforating arteries, they connect plantar metatarsal arteries to the distal end of dorsal metatarsal arteries. That's all about arterial supply on the sole of the foot.